Okay, so now I'm going to show you how to do a stars and stripes shirt. So I made the stencil with the lines in it. I put them 1 inch apart. I can also custom make these stencils for anybody that requests them also, because they don't come that way right now. And I also put the stars on the star stencil on the shirt at the same time, because I kind of want it to overlap a little bit, and so I need a sense of where the stars are going to go. And if you can see the stars right here, this is what I call an open stencil. There's no frame around it like there is with the stripes. It's an open stencil, which means the paint will spray inside the stars and around the stars. So that's what I call an open stencil, because it doesn't have a frame around it. Now, when you clean your paint out, and we're going to do the red first because we have to do red stripes here, then we have to wipe them off, then we have to move the red stripes over to here. So it's easier to do that first, get rid of that, and then go ahead and do the open stars, because that's only going to take one spray of blue going around the edges. Keep in mind, if you've cleaned out your sprayer, that you have water in the sprayer. So make sure to spray out the water so you get to the paint. Otherwise, you're going to spray water on your shirt, and that's going to dilute any of the paint that comes afterwards. And also, don't forget to put your newspaper around the edges again. Put down your washers for weights, because otherwise you're going to spray the stars and all those outside edges, that any place that you don't want the paint to go, that's of course where the paint's going to go. So here we're going to spray our red stripes. I used to do the stripes, I used to tape them off with painter's tape, blue painter's tape, or using masking tape. Doesn't make any difference. And I'd have to measure it, I'd have to line all the stars up. It was such a pain. So I thought, I'm going to make a stripe stencil so I don't have to keep doing that. Okay, again, we wipe off our washers if they have extra paint on them. I guess I had some paper towels up there. Wipe those off, otherwise they get sticky. And then we'll pick the paper up careful, keeping in mind that there is paint on the edges, so we don't want to drag that across our shirts. Pick this up right there. Now we will pick up the stencil end to end, pick it up, move it over to the newspaper, wipe it off again with the paper towels onto newspaper. Same steps that we did in the others. This one, because of course it's long, it's just easy to draw the paint down to this end and wipe it off. Sorry if my arm's getting away of the camera. It's not easy to do one person videos. We don't have the luxury of having multi cameras. And then take kind of a open edge. You've got most of the paint off. And then just kind of go back. Just make sure you get everything off there. Not everything's going to come off. It's going to start to stain pink. That's okay. Then I'm going to turn it over, and I'm just going to make sure that I don't have any paint, any really wet paint on the other side. Okay, so now I'm going to take the stencil, line it up again. Now I have this one kind of a raw edge right there. I mean, it's not a raw edge. There's a strip cut out next to it, and then there's a plain one. But it kind of helps me line up my last stripe there, so that I can lay out all my stripes. Keeping in mind your star stencil is loose, so don't start jogging around with it or get it out of place. Line up that blank, that one of my red stripe is right underneath there. The open edge is lined up right there. Oh, except that's not where I want the next stripe, otherwise I'd have stripes right next to each other. Oh, good thinking. So actually, I want this stripe just right next to the stripe that I just did. I hope that makes sense, because there's a stripe underneath here. Or I mean, there isn't. There's a stripe here. There's not a stripe here, but then there's going to be a stripe there. So I want to keep that open right there. Okay, so now I'm going to put my newspaper back again. Right on the edges. Use my washers. Hold it down. Get it in the way there. You can use two washers on the edge, three washers on the edge. It doesn't make any difference. Whatever makes you feel comfortable that that newspaper isn't going to let anything out. And now this time I'll use a third piece on this side, because I now happen to have three edges there. That'll be fine. Okay, so I'm going to spray my second. And you can see some of the stripe or some of the stars are right in the way there. That's fine. I want that to happen because I kind of like that overlap look. Things shouldn't look too perfect because we're hand painting. I mean, even if it's spray painting, it's still by hand. And you just don't want anything to, you know, look too perfect because what's the point? And when you're spraying, you can create shadow effects depending on how much paint you spray, you know, in one area. Running out of paint there, I'm tilting it. So I'm running out of paint a little bit there. Okay, so here I got another spray, another paper towel. Pick up my washers, wash them off. All the same steps every single time. Not much changes. You just sometimes do some shirts in more steps than others. Doesn't make any difference how you do it. Just get the job done. And if you can't figure something out, email me or call me. And I will do my best to help figure something out for you. Now I'm going to wipe this red off just because it's such excess right there. Pick this one up on this edge. And always carefully pick up your newspaper because it's going to want to grab on to the stencil because it's wet. So you just want to pick it up kind of careful there. Okay, so now again, we pick this up. You see there, you see what I mean? The way I was laying it out, I was going to have a red stripe right next to a red stripe, and that would be stupid because then I wouldn't have my spacing. Okay, so now we just wipe off these strips again. I got to hold it down at the top because it's kind of long and lanky here. It's like this. Okay. Pull this out. Yeah, keep in mind, you might end up just putting paint back on if you don't watch where your paper towel is folded, just like that was. And since I'm not going to use this again right away, really the paint could dry on there. Wouldn't have to get it perfectly clean again. So I'm just going to pick it up and move it off to the side. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is the blue paint. I'm just going to move this over a little bit so it's better. So you're always careful that you haven't moved your star stencil. If you did move it, it's kind of easy to see where it should go back because you spray painted some of the corners in. So now I'm going to do the blue paint. And you'll see how that'll end up. And I've sprayed out through the water. I'm going to have a little blue overlap onto the red. I like that. Kind of creates a funky look. Now I put a paper towel cutout inside my neckline. If you're only spray painting the front of the shirt, and leaving the back of the shirt white or beige or whatever, if you don't put a paper towel in there because it's a single layer right there, the paint's going to shadow effect on the back of the t-shirt. So you want to put that paper towel in there, a piece of cardboard, anything that you have handy that you want in there. Oh, now we're starting to get a funky spray there. Oh, that's okay. Let's make it do that. Sometimes sprayers, you know, get weird on you and but it just adds another texture, so I really kind of like that. But I'm just going to have to clean that sprayer back out again. I don't know if the little hole got clogged up a little bit. So I may go back later and spray this up a little bit different. I'm going to get this done here right now. So now you pick this up and put this over on top of your paper, on top of your newspaper. And you wipe off your stencil. And you can see how many times I've used this. These are kind of see-through stencils, and then when I get done with them, they're always kind of colored in some way. And this one was clear, now it looks blue because I use a lot of blue stars, a lot of Americana t-shirts. All of my products can be found on my website at www.suestuds.com. I'm going to push that together, and you always let your t-shirts dry totally before, which is about 10-15 minutes, depending on how heavy your spray is, before you add an iron-on design. Because if you add the iron-on design while it's wet, the clear plastic on the design may pick up some of the paint. And you don't want that to happen because it's going to look like a square and you're going to have, you know, kind of bicolored your. And see, now you can see where the white neckline is underneath there. I've been spraying mostly on the blue here. And we'll just put this off to the side a little bit. Let that dry. And this is what the final t-shirt's going to look like. I am putting in a Americana design on the front. It's Freedom. It's a really cool design. With Memorial Day coming up, I thought that would look really cool. And again, all of my product can be found on www.suestuds.com. Any comments, anything I could ever help with, leave a comment, or you can email me at info@suestuds.com. Again, thanks for watching.